On the day of the crash, it was last year, June last year, I had a good start in the race and I was leading as well, which was, you know, made it worse, I suppose. And I had two laps to go. I was clearly leading my class on a long corner called Gerrard's. I went a bit wide, put a back wheel on the grass, and that spun the car around. I went straight across the track and hit a tyre wall. Within a few minutes, a doctor came over to the car and they had to cut the roof off the car to get me out. Put me on a bodyboard with a neck brace and took me to a medical centre. And I was in bad pain at the bottom of my back, but you know, a few months later I was fine, no problems.
We join Stuart and his two sons on a Sunday morning as they travel to Brands Hatch for an end of season track day.
It's too early. Yeah, we're going racing. Well, we're not going racing, we're going to the track day.
Boink.
I've been comb racing with my dad since I was about 10 or 11, and I'm usually pit crew, so I'm responsible for doing all the timing and helping fix the car if it goes wrong. I had a big crash last year. My old man hit a tyre wall very hard and wrote the car off, and they had to cut the roof off to get him out. I was the only one there at the time because my brother, who usually comes, wasn't there, and most of our pit crew for one reason or another weren't, so it was quite tricky. Quite emotional, and you're the only person there, and you know he was on a sort of stretcher and all that sort of stuff. So, but that's sort of the worst thing that's happened in the time we've been doing it.
Crash at Marion. Luckily, I wasn't there to witness it, because I think personally it would have probably screwed me up if I was away that weekend. But I saw it when I got home. Car was a total write off. You could see where the roof had to be cut off. It was all smashed up down one side. Dad was a bit shaken up, still in a bit of pain. He had quite a bad back and lost a couple of his teeth. It was sort of kind of brought home how dangerous racing is when we saw how bad the car was. You don't sort of tend to think it's going to happen to you until it does. It was a bit of a mad one, really.
We wanted to find out how it all started. We went over to the pit lane to speak to one of Stuart's long-term racing partners.
Well, my name's Mark Lewis, known as Scary. I've known Stuart for God knows how many years. We started track days in 83. So anyway, we've been doing it about 16 years so far. He's blown a few cars up, crashed a few. He had a big crash last year at Mallory and wrote the car off completely. And then he didn't do any more racing that year. And then Mallory Park this year again, he blew it up. The same track, so Mallory Park isn't his favourite circuit. And then today we're just here to test an airbox out, and then we're going to try next year again.
What got me into racing was I used to do track days where you just take your road car around the track, and I enjoyed that so much I thought I'd like to do this properly and race a car. That's how I started doing it, really. That was back in about 89.
This car here, that's my one of my first racing cars.
First track I ever won at, we don't race there anymore, it's a track called Castle Combe. That was probably about 1991, I had my first class win, and that was at Castle Combe. It's such a good buzz, you know, especially when you line up on the grid with about 30 cars waiting for the green light to come on, and you all charge off, and it's a very good buzz.
Stuart drove around the track with speeds hitting 120 miles per hour. But after such a serious accident, did Stuart really not have any fears?
The track I crashed at, this year I had to race there again and I was a bit wary. So the day before I walked around the circuit looking at all the corners, and we stopped and had a good look at the corner I crashed at, and put you off a little bit. But once I got into racing around there again, I was fine, not a problem.
After the crash, he was saying that you know, he wasn't going to go as quick and he was just going to sort of poodle around. But, you know, we all knew that wasn't going to last for very long because he's a born racer. So even after a big crash, he still went straight back out there and drives just as fast as he did before because he's a loon.
But, I mean, you know, it's one of those things, he had to go back and do it again. He decided he was going to carry on racing, much against Maureen's ideas. But, yeah, so I don't think he was that, you know, obviously concerned that he needed to go around there again, but that was it, really. I don't think he's got any fears about it.
The day we were at Brands was the first time Tom had ever driven his dad's racing car.
Well, today I'm actually going to have a go around the track and see if I can actually drive, because it's one thing driving quickly on the road, but it's a completely different thing driving around a track quickly. So I'm going to have a go, and if I'm any good, then I might have to take over when the old man gets a bit too old. Well, they're not telling that. But yeah, I definitely want to have a go.
The whole of my family worried about me racing again, especially my wife. But I convinced them that I won't drive so competitively now and just go out there to have fun. As you can see, I've got a few trophies. I have done a lot of winning, so I don't mind. I'm out there more now to enjoy it.
I'd definitely love to go into motor racing myself. Obviously, when my dad eventually hangs up his gloves, that can be 10 years' time. My dad, he'll probably race till he's about 80, but I'm hoping to get into it. I'd say within the next 5 years, maximum.
A lot of people ask me when I'm going to give up racing. I'm currently 56 at the moment, and we have got another driver that's 60, and that could be the age when I might stop, when I'm in about 4 years' time. And by then, hopefully Tom will be having a go, and I'll probably be his pit crew. I'll still be involved in building the cars, and it'll be me on the pit all time in him. That's how I think it will go.
Lost a couple of his teeth, so I think he's got a new set of teeth now.
I enjoy racing, it's good.
It's not so much about top end, it's about the speed you go around corners at.
I think he should be racing still, it's what he loves.
I'll just come along for the beer.
If you're frightened of doing it, you shouldn't be out there doing it, basically.